It's a beautiful day in the cave today, a beautiful day for Bat Buddies. But you know, sometimes you gotta get out. Hey, Bat Buddies, I thought we'd go on a little field trip today. Down to the dollar store in Gotham City. Get out of the cave for a little while and see what we can find to put together our great Bat Utility Belt. Made out of just things we find for maybe under 10 bucks. Let's see what we can do together. But first, I gotta knock you out with this special spray. See you down there.
$8.76. Cool.
No Bruce Wayne. I'm sure his is probably at least 8 million.
But it'll work for us.
Let's go back to the cave. Where did I park that Batmobile?
Almost forgot. Hey, I gotta spray you again. Alright, Bat Buddies, wake up. I don't know how to tell you this, but some of you drool. But that's okay. Batgirl does too, but you know, it's a little more attractive with her. Hey, listen, let's get over to the workshop, let's take the great things we found, and let's put them together, put a special finish on them, make something that's uniquely yours to put your costume together with a great Bat Utility Belt for under 10 bucks. Come on!
Let's take a look at what we got here. $8.75.
Look at that.
Little cylindrical little jobby-doo thing. Black and yellow, hey, can't beat it. I don't know what these are, they're arm guards, but you know, we could chop these, and they've got texture. Now look at this. One piece, $1. Cut that in half. You've got two nice shiny cylindrical tubes. Then you cut this off. If you round this out, you've got a nice shiny belt buckle. But of course you have to have a bat. Hey, we got a bat, yeah! Now this has got a nice texture on it. I'm gonna cut this off, put these together, reshape them, there you go. We've got two dry erasers, $1 each, and that's gonna be just the right shape. And then have the tubes in between, these little jobby doos in between. Then I have this, a little bit of texture. This is what we're gonna use for the belt, and we can actually cut things out. Like if I don't like the bat for any reason, I can cut a bat out of that. But if I cut this, it's going to be a little bit, not perfectly straight. It's gonna wanna curve up. But if I cut the middle part just right, I think I should be able to make a belt out of that. The only question is, will anything stick to it? I'm gonna rough it up with sandpaper. Once I do that, I think we'll have a lot better adhesion. First thing, I need the belt itself, all right? So I'm gonna cut this out. I've got all kinds of other things we can add, like found objects and things like that. And you don't have to even go to the dollar store. You don't even have to, you know, you don't even have to spend $8.75. You could go in your closet, you can go in your garage. You go out walking down the street and see what people throw out of their cars. I'm constantly bringing things back to work with. I've been doing that ever since art school. We used to go out and do found objects. We'd go out on the weekends, walk the railroad tracks, and things like that. Yeah. You gotta have materials. It's hard to make things if you don't have materials. Yeah, I'd say almost 40 years now, I've been collecting materials to do art projects with. So it's really not that surprising that I would do the same thing for the Batman stuff. It does go up a little bit in the back, but, you know, I think that this is gonna probably be all right. I'm gonna try to just hurry through this and show you how fast and easy this can be done. I liked this texture here. You can't see what's behind it. You might as well say, hey, you know, it's got smoke bombs in there or some other kind of bad gadget. Nobody would know that there's nothing behind it. I don't know. Obviously this I know for sure I'm gonna use for the buckle, and this I'm gonna use for some cylinders. But the cylinders, once I cut it in half, they're gonna be smaller than this. So my real hope here is that this dry eraser will look good. I think it's gonna be hollow inside, so I'm gonna leave the felt right on it. Oh yeah, there's all kinds of great gadgets in there. I don't know what's in there, but you know, what does he do? I mean, pull something out of there. Now this is the big one here, and you'll have to have a hacksaw or something like that. In fact, I have a hacksaw here. I might be able to do it right here without getting the electrical saw out. What do you think? Can we do it with a hacksaw? Yeah, I think we might be able to do it. Well, that's one way to do it. All right, two cylinders. Not exactly sure what I'm gonna do yet. I'm just getting things figured out. I got options. It looks pretty bad right now, doesn't it? That's the whole point. I was hoping it would. Because if it looks bad and then it can look good, that's a good thing, right? Now, you could just have a belt buckle with a bat on it that opens up. Everything's a Batman item. Everything you see is a Batman item. You just don't know it yet, but you will. I make pieces that people can use that are harder to make than this. So this is unusual for me to do this, but I have done it many times. And I'm just showing you, that you can have some fun. Let's say you want to buy a few things. You want to buy a cowl, a cape, you know, put together some kind of undersuit. You just don't have it all together right off the bat. No problem. No problem. Make your suit for yourself. These are just a basic set of screwdrivers. We're just going to take off the basic set of $1 screwdrivers. Gosh, we've got enough here. We almost could make two belts. I don't know. Maybe those are little... Who knows what happens when you press that? I am holding a thermal detonator! Okay, so anyway, it's already black and yellow. Gee whiz. We're not going with the theme black and yellow here today, so that's probably not going to help me, but maybe I'll put a little black and yellow in there. Okay, so here we go. There's everything laid out, all out of the package, ready to go. We're looking at $8.75. Enough to make a utility belt really easily. It's going to look really bad, isn't it? I'm going to show you how bad it's going to look first, and then we're going to make it look good. So it's going to be a two-step process. I'm relatively confident that nothing's going to stick to this really slick plastic. I want to put that texture on it. Because, you know, nowadays, everything seems to be texturized, you know, the high-tech stuff that you can make. Let's talk about what you would do if you didn't texturize it. This is one of the things you want to do to your things. That's going to help a lot with things sticking. Let's do a stick test. Okay, let's do a stick test. This is just a test. We are conducting a test. Pop it on here. Boop. Here we go. A little bit of... Ooh, I love this stuff. Been using this since I was in the movie industry. Yeah, we did a whole cake. A whole cake for Problem Child 2. Out of Zappa Gap and foam core. You can see it at the end. Lands on LaWanda. Let me just make sure this is set well. And you're not going to fight crime. Very important. Always remember, you're not going to fight crime. Okay. So, that would be like... That would be one of them, right there. Let's do a yank it off test. Oh, comes off. That's not good. Mostly cured, didn't stick. Okay. Good to know, we're not disappointed. Okay. Thomas Edison invented the light bulb in 1,000 steps. I'm going to invent this utility belt 992. Yeah. Okay, so that won't work. I'm relatively confident I could pull it off, and I'm going to because that's not where I want it. But it took a lot more to pull it off. So I'm going to keep on working with that a little bit. Let's get a little more skeffy first, because right now we're just doing tests. Then we're going to start the assembly process. All right. So there, we're really scuffy. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take just a rag and maybe a little bit of alcohol. And I'm going to make sure that there's no loose dust particles on there. Now we're going to do the glue test again, okay? I've already got some glue on there. I'll scrape that off later. Let's try the other one we haven't used yet. Going right in the scuffy part. Boom. Here we go. Give it time to set up. If this was my finger, you know it'd stick really well. So, Murphy's Law, right? Why won't it stick to the black utility belt? It'll stick to your finger, right? We should make all utility belts out of finger material. Then it would work. Okay, it's still coming off. Whenever I have an issue with the material and Zappa Gap, I'll always switch over. I'll always switch over to hot glue. Now, right now, without taking a lot of time to figure out where I put the hot glue gun, I'm just gonna try it and see if it works. All right, there's a nice little bit of hot glue on there. All right, let's take this cylinder, pop it on that hot glue there. I wanna curve this. I could do it with just bending it, but it won't be as perfect of a curve. That's pretty good. I don't think you need any more than that. Now, we're gonna put this right in the center. Oh, look at how great that hot glue works. That's what we're gonna use, yeah. So I'm gonna take and I'm gonna sand these down first and prep them before I put them on. Hey, Batman doesn't always look great when he's all super shiny. He looks better when he's been out there a little bit. I like to age my stuff. Age it a couple different ways, all over the place. So, there you go. This is the way to... He's been through a few battles now. gonna put that thing right in the middle.
And so there's no sharp edges where you cut it off. I used a belt sander in the other part of the cave a moment ago.
Alright, we'll do the dot method. That'll work. Always keep a lead dive belt around, weighting things down. And while that's cooling down a little bit, I can think about what I'm going to do with the rest of the stuff. Alright, now the fun part. Some spray paint. These are already black, but the spray paint helps you to do what you're going to do. So go ahead and put a little bit on there. Okay, it's time to make our bat work. There's plenty of material on you to make good stuff. And a really nice pattern on there. Yep, the work's already done for you. And there's a nice pattern on there. I mean, what else can you ask for? Okay. Well, I guess you can ask for it to be exactly the shape and size that you need for your thing, right? I'm gonna take a black Sharpie marker. See what I can do with my bat that I like. What can I do with my bat that I like? Shorten this up a little bit. Let the piece do most of the work. So that's one half. And then we're gonna go cut on down there. The head. So I'm just gonna take this and flip it over and match it up with the other side. And I'm going to cut this exactly the same. Keep in mind, this is a dollar. Yeah, you can experiment with the shape. Get it exactly the way you want it. It's pretty close already. Now I know that the Zappa Gap will work for this, so I'm not even gonna do any tests. I got enough experience. Yeah, that's plenty good. Maybe take a little bit more off, or just French curve these outer ones just a little bit more than they are. That's probably all you need. I think I'll point the ears just a little bit more. So we're gonna put that on there, with a little bit of super glue. We know the metal will stick to the Zappa Gap, and we know that this material sticks because I already stuck two pieces together to get it to stick. You don't need a very thick amount of this, so what I usually do is I get it applied, I know it's even, move it around to the edges a little bit with a Q-tip. Make sure it's evenly distributed. It doesn't have to be very thick in very many areas. And just take your time and put it on there. Let's go ahead and bust on through this. We want to get this thing out, right? That's gonna go up a little bit. Maybe you want it to go down, you know, a little lower to start out. I want to hold this up here, and I want to say, well, do I want that to be, yeah, that's too big for the front. Maybe I'll use one of those little cylinder things there. Take some more glue, put down a cylinder. Have you ever seen anybody do this without a glue gun? It's crazy, isn't it? So there it is, there's one. Now, since I have those in the front, I think the silver is going to look better by the silver. I could put one of those spacers in there. And you know, if you don't like it, go down and spend another $8 and do it again. No harm, no foul. I'm going to finish this up here in half an hour here. And I want the belt to give a little bit underneath them. We know the belt's going to curve and the dry eraser's not. But the felt does give it a little bit of flex. So now we're almost ready for the fun part. Now I can decide, do I want to do something with these? Well, you know, I can. Because it's going to be around underneath the cape. You're not going to really be able to tell what that is. Here, I could stop right now. I could just stop right now and say, that's it. We're done. We don't need to go around anymore. I'm not even going to use these. I could use them. I'm not going to use this. So, you know, I've got enough here. I've got enough right here to make another belt. I just don't have another one of these. There's your Batman utility belt. 5 minutes, 10 minutes, you know, once you prep the pieces. Here's the fun part. Are we all in agreement? This looks like stuff you get from a dollar store right now. Pretty junky, still could almost use it the way it is, but not good enough, right guys? Now we're gonna get to where it gets to be fun, and you see stuff happening. Now, I do have my texture that I could put in there, but for the purpose of this video, I'm not going to, but I wanna keep this video fast. I wanna keep this video something you could do really, really fast. And if I start doing all these other things, it's gonna take longer than a half an hour. I'll take my little yellow things off and put them back on. I like to use brown. I always like the classic Batman. In fact, I can tell you the absolute truth, guys. Of all the Batman videos that I've seen, all the Batman movies we've all watched together, I like Adam West because it's fun. It's nostalgic.
I grew up with it. I like it. But the truth of the matter is, the real Batman that I want to see hasn't been done yet. And my friend always says, why don't you be the guy that does it? Yeah, well, that's fine. If you're independently wealthy or you've got a lot of connections in Hollywood, that's fine. I want to see the Batman that starts out without all the high-tech stuff. That's what I want to see. And he's going to be a little bit, you know, everything he's going to have is going to be a little bit older. Because, let's face it, you're going to live in a different day and age if you don't have the high-tech stuff. If you're a Batman that doesn't have that. You're a multi-millionaire, and you still don't have the ability of the high-tech stuff. So, that puts you in the area of, not steampunk, but where everything's a little bit older type of stuff. Some bronzes, you know, just the style of the time. Bruce Wayne and the people that he hires, they're gonna use various materials of that time, various style, trendy stuff. And things are gonna look more like that type of a thing. So when I'm designing my belt for my favorite kind of Batman, I'm going to do that. Now, I'm gonna simulate years and years worth of time with a really cruddy brush. Always use a cruddy brush. Don't use a brand new cruddy brush, use an old cruddy brush. Because if you use an old cruddy brush, the hairs aren't all separated. When you do scratches, the scratches are gonna be bigger. And they're gonna show more because you've got more of your hair clusters together. So instead of being uniform or look like a paintbrush, it's gonna look more like, what happened there? You wanna use a combination of all kinds of stuff too, guys. You don't wanna get caught up, and you don't wanna work anything to death. Who was it? I think it was Bill Alexander, maybe it was Bob Ross, said you don't wanna work it to death, because if you work it to death, then it gets muddy. It gets muddy, and you see that the artist struggled. The artist is, that what he's actually doing is he's painting his struggle. We don't wanna paint our struggle. We want the happy clouds to just appear. All right, so a lot of times what I'll do is I'll go a little bit of a dusting. So if I got too much scratches, the dusting will make it more gold. It'll take away some of that over scratchy stuff. If I don't go any farther at all, I want to show you that we've got something here. And I'm going to say the actual time to put this together was less than a half an hour. No one's going to know that this cost you $8.75. It actually costs less, because I didn't use this, and I may not, and I didn't use this, and I may not, or I might make another belt. So this belt really only cost about $7 now, because I didn't use those things. But you see, now we have what's a perfectly acceptable looking belt. Perfectly acceptable looking. For about $7, and about a half an hour's worth of time, and a couple of spritzes of gold spray paint. What you can do, and I'm gonna, just because I'm here, you know, go ahead and do more stuff. You could simulate this in other ways if you want to. Let's do it with actual cutting. Let's get a great big old. All right, let's switch tools. When in doubt, switch techniques. Don't stick with the same technique over and over again. If you see something you don't like, hit it. Hit it, I don't like those areas. Hit them, hit them. I don't wanna see what I did there. I wanna make it into something else. I want a little bit more of the silver underneath showing through in a few areas. I want the bat to have a nick out of it. Ah, there you go. Everyone's gonna be different. You're gonna do it your own way. Maybe I took a great big graze right there. Maybe I got hit by something big right there. Oh, that one almost got me. Thank goodness everything is titanium or something better than that, right? Oh, bullet hole right to the belt buckle. Another thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go and say, okay, now that I've had my fun, okay, I'm going to go and say, okay, well, when did I have too much fun? What worked? What didn't work? What was a happy accident? What didn't? You know, a lot of times I'll take different tools. And really, there is no right or wrong. And I was like, that one got gouged. That one got a great big thing across it there. You know, I'm going probably beyond what I'd want to go, and I'm going a lot faster. If I want to do like a bullet hole, I'll take some silver. So a little bit of reflection, a little bit of the metal that it's made out of before it was painted shows through on the bottoms, maybe, of the bullet holes. Maybe the bottoms where it's cutting through. It wants to go all the way through, but it doesn't. It gave you a little bit of, exposed the metal underneath. Maybe the bat is a little bit exposed. Maybe it's a different material, I don't know. Maybe we don't want to go totally gold with that. Maybe a few times something exposed the material underneath it. And so you go around each one of the hits. Make a multifaceted hit. There you have it. I'm gonna bring the camera around here, take a picture of this thing for you. And you're gonna see the end result of about a half an hour's worth of work and $7, okay? That is perfectly acceptable to wear with a custom-made hybrid Batman costume. Nobody's gonna come up and go, what? Is that a dry eraser? No, they're gonna, all right, man, that looks cool.
Okay, there you have it, guys. All right.
Don't do it in a half an hour for a video. Take some time. Work each one of those modulation things the way you want them to be. Not the way I did them, just to get it done quick.
Maybe I want a little bit more accentuation between the surfaces in a few areas. Okay, so I made the bat a little more pronounced. You know, you can fine tune it, do it all over again. Hey, take another half an hour and another $8 and do it again.
And I still got all this left to start working with another belt. Just take a couple pieces of Velcro, put them on the ends, fasten them behind, okay? And you're in business, just like that. All right, guys, Paul Roberts, Artsy One, the $8 dollar store belt in a half hour or less. There you go. Till next time, give me some ideas. Hey, by the way, I like the likes. Do some comments. Give me some ideas. Tell me what you think, and then you'll give me some ideas I can do other videos. I do this for camaraderie and fun with my bat buddies, and so I always want to have the comments. Not just with emails, but go ahead, say it out loud. Say, hey, man, that's a piece of junk. Yeah, it is a piece of junk. And you don't want to keep this for your whole career. This is your starter belt. You needed something right before Halloween or right before a convention. You didn't have any budget left. Your wife went and spent all the money on the groceries. Get $8? Well, if you can do something for $8, sure, you can have a utility belt, honey. Well, now you can. Paul Roberts, Artsy One, artsyone.com, artsyone at earthlink.net. See you later, Bat Buddies. Well, there you have it. $10 or less. Have some fun, guys. This hobby is all about having a good time. Let's use our creativity to make something that no one else has. Hey, Batman has so many different looks. You could just make something that's uniquely yours for $10 or less. Don't do what I'm doing. Go out and do something that you want to do to make your own thing special for your type of suit.